दिस इज अ सेल, दिस इज द बाइफॉस्फोलिपिड सेल मेम्ब्रेन एंड दिस इज द साइटोप्लाज्म। हेयर गोल्गी कॉम्प्लेक्स, माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया, दीज आर सम ऑफ द साइटोप्लाज्मिक एंजाइम्स हेयर लाइक माइलोपेरोक्सीडेज, प्रोटीनेज 3, MDF5, सिंथेटेज, ZO1। दीज आर द साइटोप्लाज्मिक एंजाइम्स एंड इन साइड दिस न्यूक्लियस देयर इज DNA। DNA undergoes replication with this enzyme called topoisomerase 1, which is also called SCL70. This undergoes protein synthesis through RNA. DNA forms RNA with the enzyme RNA polymerase 3, and this in turn undergoes protein synthesis. Similarly, in chromosome, you know that these DNA are compacted inside this chromosome, and in chromosome you have centromere. Inside this nucleus there are variety of proteins like ribonuclear protein. There are multiple types like U1, U3, Smith protein, TH, TO. These are name of the proteins. And on the biphospholipid cell membrane, there are some antigens like glycoprotein, beta-2 glycoprotein, cardiolipin. Okay, so these are the cell membrane proteins. These are the cytoplasmic enzymes. These are the components inside the nucleus. And now in autoimmune disease, there is increased inflammation, and due to that, cell undergoes apoptosis. And when the cell dies in large numbers, what happens that these cytoplasmic components, these nuclear components gets leaked outside. And when the blood sees these protein molecules, that it seems that it is foreign, and B cells starts producing antibody to these components because they are actually never exposed outside in the blood because they are contained inside this membrane. But when there is rapid death of the cells and they are not sufficiently cleared by immune system, then B cells starts forming antibody against these components. Normally when I tap like this, what happens that some cell death occurs. Okay, so some cell got died and those components got leaked, and those were cleared by immune system. And when I do like repeatedly, I do this, then what happens that multiple cell dies. And let's suppose immune system is not able to clear sufficiently, then what happens that antibody starts forming to these components. If I get tested with these antibodies, like these, let's suppose anti-dsDNA or anti-nuclear antibody, anti-histone antibody, I may get positive, but that is transiently positive. It may disappear later. And in a patient, if these are positive, like if anti-nuclear antibody is positive, it does not mean that the patient has disease or will have disease. Some patients have anti-nuclear antibody positive, anti-dsDNA positive for lifelong, but they do not develop clinical disease or pathological disease. So we don't do these tests for these components unless we suspect there is clinical disease, because these may be positive as well, because you know that cell undergoes lysis, death, and these might be encountered. B cells might encounter these components and may form antibodies. But unless it causes pathological disease, we don't test these antibodies. So if antibody forms against MDA5, anti-synthetase, or anti-JO1, these cytoplasmic enzymes, if these are formed in high concentration, then we suspect that patient may have myositis. Because in myositis, what happens that these myocytes die and these cytoplasmic components get leaked, and these enzymes are particularly increased concentration in myocytes. So if you see these antibodies against these components, then we should suspect that maybe polymyositis, dermatomyositis. We can see antibodies against proteinase 3, myeloperoxidase, in some small vessel vasculitis, like myeloperoxidase may be positive in eosinophilic granulomatosis with polyangiitis, and also can be positive in inflammatory bowel disease. This myeloperoxidase is called PNK, एनका स्टैंड फॉर एंटी न्यूट्रोफिल साइटोप्लाज्मिक एंटीबॉडी एंड दिस प्रोटीनेज इज 3 इज कॉल्ड सी एनका. सो इफ दिस कंपोनेंट्स गेट्स एक्सपोज्ड टू द ब्लड देन एंटीबॉडी ऑल्सो फॉर्म्स अगेंस्ट दिस प्रोटीन्स एंड दैट कॉजेज इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ ब्लड वेसल्स. सिमिलरली एंटीबॉडी कैन फॉर्म अगेंस्ट सेल मेम्ब्रेन्स लाइक दिस बीटा ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन कार्डियोलिपिन. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एंटी कार्डियोलिपिन एंटीबॉडी एंटी बीटा टू ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन एंटीबॉडी एंड ऑल्सो देर इज अदर फॉस्फोलिपिड कंपोनेंट्स अगेंस्ट दोज इफ एंटीबॉडी फॉर्म्स देन वी कॉल्ड लुपस एंटीकोगुलेंट. एंड I already told that antibody can form against all these components. For example, if you see antibody against histone, it may be positive in SLE, drug-induced SLE. If antibody against dsDNA, it can be in systemic lupus erythematosus. A Smith protein is also highly specific. If you see antibody against RNA polymerase 3, then we should suspect that it may be systemic sclerosis. In topoisomerase also it can form in systemic sclerosis. In limited systemic sclerosis we get anti-centromere antibody. In UNRNP we get in mixed connective tissue disease. So once this cell dies, these multiple proteins gets released, but I am telling you that this is highly specific for SLE. Some like Rola, these are highly specific for Sjögren syndrome. Then how does it happen? So when the cell dies, when the nuclear components get exposed, the antibody will form against all those components. Yes, in SLE also, even if you test all these tests, patient may have RNA polymerase 3, patient may have UNRNP, patient may have Rola positive. Okay, so in one autoimmune disease, there is not only one test is positive, but I am saying that antibody, if is in high titer, that has high likelihood of SLE. But other components also can be positive, but that is in low titer. And this there has been multiple studies has been done that have analyzed that if which antibody is in high titer, then which disease it correlates. Like if it is Rola positive, then we suspect that if it is in high titer, then we suspect that it may be Sjögren syndrome. Similarly, if RNA polymerase 3 is there and if SCL70 is in high titer, then we should suspect that patient have systemic sclerosis and that is rapidly progressive. Patient may have rapidly progressive skin disease or patient has high risk of scleroderma renal crisis. And if patient has anti-centromere antibody in high titer, then we can predict that patient has limited cutaneous systemic sclerosis and don't have such worse prognosis compared to patients having SCL70 and RNA polymerase 3. So in one patient there might be multiple antibody might be positive, but this is the titer is important to distinguish between different autoimmune disease. And you can see these beta 2 glycoprotein cardiolipin antibody positive in antiphospholipid antibody syndrome. If antibody form against this phospholipid, we call antiphospholipid. And that syndrome, that if clinical manifestations that we get, that is called antiphospholipid syndrome. Similarly, when the cell dies, let's suppose this cell death occurs, then there are various proteins and these proteins undergoes conversion to citrullin. And if antibody forms against this citrullin, then we call anti-citrullin peptide. This is a peptide, this is also a protein. This is called anti-CCP. And if this is present in high concentration, then we can suspect rheumatoid arthritis because it has been shown that it has high specificity for rheumatoid arthritis. Although not much sensitive, like sensitivity is like 70%. But specificity is high. But if it can be positive in SLE as well, it can be positive in systemic sclerosis as well in low titer. Okay, so antibody to any component can be positive in any autoimmune disease, and the only titer matters or titer directs towards the diagnosis of disease. Similarly, what is rheumatoid factor? Rheumatoid factor. So this is antibody, IgM antibody against Fc portion of IgG. So this is Fc portion, and this is the Fab fragment portion. So if there is antibody, you know that it is pentameric. IgM is pentameric antibody. This has five components. This is pentameric, and so if this pentameric antibody is directed towards Fc portion of IgG, then we call this rheumatoid factor. So here what we are seeing, this is IgG. So if it is IgG, it means there is some underlying chronic disease already undergoing, because IgG means there is some chronic process. That's why IgG has formed. And on top of that chronic disease, if there is some acute event, then IgM forms. So IgM has formed, and this is itself attacking the Fc portion of IgG. So antibody against antibody is forming. So where we can see this? In chronic process, I told that this is chronic immunoglobulin. So in chronic disease, like hepatitis chronically going on, if tuberculosis chronically going on, in HIV chronically going on, or rheumatoid arthritis chronically going on. So in these chronic conditions, we can see this rheumatoid factor.